PIMLWebServices web services lets you manage tools and tool runs through ASP.NET web services interface. Any internet connection enabled devices can communicate with the web services and transfer data between the PIMLWebServices database and a mobile device. If your mobile device is web enabled, then the communication is simple. Once PIMLWebServices has been configured and a web server with wireless capabilities has also been configured, by clicking on the data transfer arrows, data can be transferred back and forth between the PDA and a web server. Through web services, you can retrieve the system data time, any global settings, selected tool definitions as a data set, the user database in PIMLWebServices as a data set. You can also upload from the PDA to the PC any logs and tool run data as a data set. Let's see an example of this. In section 3, we have already shown how to configure the web services after installing that option and going to IIS in your web server to ensure that the web server has been properly configured under the server name, websites. We created a new folder, or rather a virtual directory under the default website with the appropriate permissions. We also show how to go to Internet Explorer and check for a proper connection by browsing through your server name, PIML Web Services folder, to the PIMLWebServices.asmx file. In here, there is an option to test the connection, where we can invoke the connection, and if we receive the following window with the SQL database name and version and the PI server name, that means that our connection is working properly. Additionally, we need to go to PIMLWebServices, and under mobile devices, mobile device settings, we need to ensure that we have the proper settings. Let me go ahead and connect my device to the PC by simulating the device going back into the cradle. I can see ActiveSync now connecting to the PDA, AutoSync updating the information in the PDA, and now as soon as this is over, I will be able to open PIMLWebServices and check on the device settings. I close connection, open PIMLWebServices. I'm going to log in as an administrator, and I want to check on the mobile devices settings. In here, I have the path to the database, a temporary folder, and the web server address. And here I'm going to enter the name of my web server along with the location of the web services folder and the PIMLWebServices.asmx file. I would also like to show you other features that are options in here, such as the single user mode, and in this case let's select Bob as the only person who can use the PDA, a single tour mode, the enable smart minimize icon on the device, and we must have the enable web services checked if we want to use web services. I click OK and the data was saved. and I should be able to use it in the PDA now. Once I've completed making all the configuration changes in Manual Logger for wireless data transfer, all I have to do is put my PDA in the cradle and let me go ahead and simulate that so that the configuration changes can be uploaded to the PDA. Since I am not creating any new tools, only changing configuration settings for wireless collection, this can be uploaded by AutoSync. Once the transfer of data is completed, I can close the window and I can remove the PDA from the cradle, and I am ready to go to the field and collect some data and transfer that data wirelessly. So let me go ahead and perform a tool run. I'm going to open Manual Logger Mobile, and if, as you remember, I'm on the single user, so there is no need to sign on. It is assumed that Bob is the only one using this PDA. I can see that I only have one tour because I also selected the option of single tour in my PDA. So I will be taken directly to the tour that I want to perform, doing a tour run at 3:45. I'm going to click OK and collect some data during my tour. Now I'm going to very quickly collect this data. In here, I want to show you what's going to happen when I do this tool run and transfer my data to the server. Remember, my signature was another requirement that I selected from the tool options. I have my tool run now for EDG tour. Let me collect a couple of additional runs. Let me do one more and show you now. This is going to be at 4:13 p.m. Another option that I had selected from the tour options when this tour was created was to be able to use the previous values in the drop-down menu. So I can see here some of the previous values that were enter. I can use those values. It's an easy way to enter data when data doesn't change very often. I will go ahead and type the rest of the values. I'm ready to finish this run and save the data. My signature. Another feature that I wanted to show you very quickly, let me perform one more run in here. When I create these runs, I can always, for each one of these tags, click on the graph and see the trend for that data. I can see what the values were. The last two have been 80, and that applies to each one of the tags. I can see the one value of 80 here for the tag. Let me go ahead and discard and close this run. I do not want to save the changes. I am now ready to send the data wirelessly to the server. Now that I collected my two runs, I am ready to send the data back to the server wirelessly from the field. I have two runs that I can send to the server. There are a couple of ways in which I can do this. I can click on these arrows, which will initiate a bi-directional data transfer to the web server. What that means is that I will be sending my tool run information with all of the data, but I will also be downloading information from the server, and I will be deleting my tour information in the PDA. The preferred method to upload the information is by going to File, Send Data to Host. By selecting this option, and I will be doing that right now, I will only be sending information from the PDA to the server, and I will be keeping my tour information so that my EDG tour is not deleted from the PDA. Here I will have to enter login information for the web server. This is a username and password at the web server. The domain in my case is virtuallabs.com. This is information that you will have to obtain from your network administrator. And we'll wait and receive confirmation that the data transfer has been successful. Now, let me repeat that when manual logger transfers data by using the arrows or the bidirectional communication, manual logger mobile erases all existing tour data during the update data from host step. If there is previously collected data on the mobile device that has not yet been sent to the manual logger desktop database or to PI directly, it is erased if we accept the communication. So to transfer this collected data prior to reinitializing our mobile database, we can send the data to host feature, and that's what I'm doing right now. The preferred method is to click on File and Send Data to Host to send the information to the PI server and not lose the tour information here in my PDA. The data transfer is going to take a few minutes as the PDA communicates with the server. And we can see that the data transfer has been successful. So we can click OK. And we see that we still have our tour in the PDA, but the tour run information has been transferred to the server. So let's go to manual logger, open manual logger, and see if the tours were transferred. Here I have my completed tour that was performed at 4:13 by Bob, and it was wirelessly transferred back to manual logger.